Get ready to match the stars. Gary Burghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wickes, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reimer.
Johnny Olson, friends. Got a good lively bunch there and a lively bunch at home, and I greet all of our celebrities. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you again, too.
Nice to see you again, darling.
What brings you to Los Angeles? As if I didn't know.
Listen, I got to tell you something. You know, Johnny Olson introduces our celebrities one at a time. They all rush out here.
Yeah.
Well, Betty White was a little late.
Right.
Oh,
she was doing corrective makeup or facial surgery or something. And she ran. Let's say this is the, you know, the entrance, this door here. And she was running like an inch. I tell you, I cracked up. You are too much. Now listen, this is the last time you will be late.
I promise.
You will be on time.
I will be here
happy
every day.
Because the last time she was here, you know, her mom is always here. Tess,
yes.
With her. And the last time she was here, Tess wasn't with her. And she was not well.
But now she's well.
And there she is.
Welcome back, Tess.
And are we glad?
There she is. She's a sweet lady. Nice to have you with us, Tess. Okay. Now, while we got it going, let's say hello to Mary Manny and Madeline Tingle over here. This lady, Mary, is our current champ. She has won $7,850, and she's only been with us 2.5 years. She's won 6 games, and she's being challenged by Madeline. Madeline there. Madeline, you ain't doing so good, are you?
No.
You ain't got nothing. Where are we? Beginning of round two. So it's 2-0 in favor of the champ. And we'll finish this game in a moment or so. But first, we want to present this message for you. Here we go. I will push this button, reveal our second and final round questions, ask Madeline to make a selection.
I'll try A again.
You want A? Mm-hmm. Everybody plays.
Good old.
All right. The nurse said to the psychiatrist.
Oh, it's my question.
Right. It's all for you. The nurse said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, there's the patient who thinks he's a fish. He's the one with the blank hanging out of his mouth." See that one over there? That's the patient who thinks he's a fish. The one with a blank hanging out of his mouth. He's the one who thinks he's a fish. Easy, right?
Easy.
It's easy for me.
Easy for you.
Easy for you.
Easy for us.
Good.
Easy for us. Easy for
us. Difficult for them up here. There, now you got it.
You got it?
You're
right. She got it. Got it.
Oh, good. Splendid. Madeline Tingle. The nurse said to the psychiatrist, Doctor, listen to me. There's the patient over there. He's the one who thinks he's a fish, the one with the blank hanging out of his mouth.
Hook.
Hook it is for her.
Steal my heart.
Please. Gary, what do you say?
I've seen the one that got away. I said Hook.
Hook. And one for Madeline. Hello, Brett. All right, cutie pie.
I started to say cat, but then I realized that would have been silly, right?
Crazy.
I said Hook.
Atta girl. Oh, boy.
Hot chicken snack. Hi, Beth.
You look very attractive today,
thank
my
you.
Dear. Yes.
Didn't we have fun last night?
Shh, oh. Quiet, Beth. Hello, Charles. All right. That's three for her. Now we come to the lady who plays a nurse in Doc, or
right.
The nurse in Doc,
right.
Mary Wickes. The nurse said to the psychiatrist, "Doctor, there's a patient over there. He's the one, he thinks he's a fish. He's the one with the blank hanging out of his mouth."
Well, I thought of Jaws, and at first I thought of a man hanging out of his mouth. And I thought that's rather weird, so I said Hook.
Good for you. That's four for her.
Now,
I'm the guy who plays Doc in a show called Nurse.
There it is. Five for Madeline. Now, Miss Betty.
Do you ever treat detectives?
Sometimes, yeah.
That makes you a dick knock.
Hook it is. Really? That lady. Now married.
Weird.
You have been challenged. Madeline has matched all of our celebrities. To achieve a tie and stay in the game, you must match all of the celebrities, and remaining the ones you didn't match the last time you
Madeline's
played.
Madeline's crying because she matched all the celebrities.
Right, she is. So you don't play this round.
Why not? Because I was so good the last time.
That's one. No, in the, okay. The previous
The other person was good.
Right.
You were your usual rotten self, the other person.
She's so jealous of me. She's
Anytime
just another
you're ready,
face.
Children.
Oh, me and Richard.
Oh, yes, it is your show.
Yes. Howdy Doody said, I went to the doctor, and he told me that I have the worst disease a puppet can get. I have terminal blanks.
I don't remember how to do it. I'm too young.
Okay.
Terminal.
You ever see Radar of MASH?
I'm good at this,
no.
How is he? You hear from him. Does he ever write to you?
He's a terminal accident.
He's a sweet fellow.
Yes, he is. He's quite a nice person. Where is this going, Gene?
I don't know. Yeah.
I don't actually
know. Did you know that the three of us have an act? That's why we're dressed like this. It's called the Blue Denimettes.
The Blue Denimettes?
Yeah.
What do you do?
It's a Kate Thompson Williams Brothers kind of act. We're opening in Santa Ana on Friday.
Okay.
But he's the only one with the screen.
All right, everybody, you ready?
I have to demonstrate detergents myself.
Howdy doody, said I went to the doctor and he told me that I have the worst disease a puppet can get. I have terminal blanks. Take your time now. Don't want to rush you. Should
terminal
I read it
aches.
Again?
No.
No?
Terminal aches.
Terminal aches. I think the audience disapproves of that. Now you gotta match everybody. Terminal aches is what she said.
Yeah, Pinocchio passed away of it. Termites.
Terminal termites! Yes, the man in Tingle wins the game. What the rest of you have? Termites. Come on down.
I love to go
there. Congratulations to you. You hang around here for a moment or so here while we say goodbye to Mary Manny. It's been great having you with us, Mary. You're going to leave here with a bundle of money, specifically $7,850. How's that, Jeff? Is that okay? Goodbye, Mary.
How quickly they forget.
Now, as she's spinning off, we'll spin these messages just for you. Here we are with Madeline Tingle, a new winner. Now, all she has is $100 for winning the game, but she could win over $5,000 here. Are you ready to plow on ahead here?
I'm ready.
Okay. don't talk that way.
Never say that.
Wrong reading for Gene.
We really have to go on here. Where were we? Oh, yes. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Train blank. Now, the answer that group of people gave most frequently will net you $500 if you match it. If you match that middle one, that is their second most frequently given response, it's $250 and $100 for the bottom one. Whom do you call on for a little help?
Charles.
Hello, Charles.
All right. Train. Well, the first one I put was train station.
Yes. Train station. Okay.
Richard?
Training bra.
Training bra?
I like to see you get excited, Gene. I'm ready too if there means anything to you.
No, it doesn't, Richard.
Just one of those days.
Yes. One more.
Betty. Train wreck.
So, Madeline, those are the three. Train wreck, training bra, and train station. Now, you may reject all three if you wish. The choice is yours. If you got a better idea than any of those, why speak out now or forever afterwards hold your peace.
I like train station.
Train station. Okay.
I don't.
She hopes it's under the $500 number, but we'll begin at the bottom as we usually do and reveal the $100 response. Train robbers.
Hey.
That's a surprise.
Oh, I remember them well.
Yes, of course. We're looking for train station. May we see the $250 number? Train track.
That's good.
So far, nothing's happening here.
Oh, well.
It's really surprising to me.
Some guys have done pay to
go. All right, last chance for the train station. Slide it, Earl.
Oh, you got it. Congratulations.
Very good. Charles gave that to you. Excellent. Now you picked up another $500. And you got 600 all together. And you're going to play for 10 times that 500 or 5,000, Madeline. But to collect it, you got to match one, and it's time to choose one now.
Well, since my daughter says that that man up there is disguised as hoodoo, I want Charles.
You want Charles?
Hoodoo was a rat, though.
Yes, all right. You ready, Charles?
All right.
Don't be nervous, Charles. You face me, if you would, please. Here, I'll get the $5,000 question, and it reads as follows. Get a blank. Get, and I'm giving you two words, G-E-T, a blank. Get a blank. You ready? Okay. Now, I hope you got your ESP going to Charles, because you didn't get any going to me. I can't think of an answer. I hope you've got one, and it's the same one that Charles has written. Get a...
job.
Get a job. All right. Get a job, eh? Charles, she says that'll match. Face your accuser now. Here he goes.
I'm sorry. No, I said get a horse.
Get a horse.
Get a job.
Did you think of get a horse, Madeline?
Get another question.
Yes. You know, get a horse is the only thing I could think of. What else? Get away? What else is there?
Get a garbo?
Get a garbo? No, I'm sorry.
Get a job.
That's close.
I had get a small horse.
Get a horse. You had get a small horse. Yeah.
Get a horse.
Okay. Madeline, you've improved your financial position by a total of $500 here, and you're going to meet another player right now. Let's welcome Maria Whitley. Maria, you know Madeline. Now, we welcome you, my dear, and ask you to tell us as much about yourself as you care to tell us.
Okay, thank you. First of all, I want to say I'm delighted to be here.
We're delighted to have you. Aren't we delighted to have her?
Yeah. Are.
Pay attention, Charles. No, I want you to hang on every word she says.
Or give me a question.
No, wait.
I am a housewife, mother of three. We've been married 7 productive years and have 3 children, Holly, Matthew, and Eric.
Mm-hmm.
I'm married to a husband who works for the Department of Justice, and we will be leaving in 3 weeks to go to Atlanta. He has been transferred.
Okay, well, good luck to you, Maria. Thank you. We'll push the button here and ask you to make a selection in round one. You may have A or B.
I'll try A.
A it is. Here we go. Ready, are you?
What happened was, I feel I should apologize. I spilled his coffee.
Oh.
Inadvertently.
Oh, right.
And it's not on him, just on the floor. But you know how testy he gets.
He made a scene, did he?
Certainly.
Yes.
I was just in Atlanta. It's a lovely city.
There's a bus leaving in 5 minutes.
I was in Connecticut.
I'll be honest. How about
working with the three witches of Shakespeare?
Yes, right.
Okay, why don't we hear
this? Would you like to go on with the game?
Sure.
I will stand here and chat if you'd like to, but we really don't.
Isn't Dumb this Dora's, the Johnny Carson show?
No, this is not the Johnny Carson show. Dumb Dora's fiancé told her that he wanted a trial marriage. So when they went on their honeymoon, Dumb Dora brought along a blank. I want a trial marriage, so on the honeymoon, Dumb Dora brought along a blank.
A child marriage?
Trial.
Oh, a trial.
A trial.
I have to tell you something.
Yes.
I went out last night. I went into a restaurant very late last night, and the maitre d' took me to a seat. I was with another gentleman, and he said, "Why aren't you in Encino with G?" And I said, I just came back. I didn't want to disappoint.
Yeah, oh, right. Yeah. Who are you listening to?
Now you got it.
Okay, Maria Whitley, here we go. Dumb Dora's fiancé told her that he wanted a trial marriage, so when they went on their honeymoon, Dumb Dora brought along a blank.
A lawyer.
A lawyer is a good answer, Maria. There are a couple of other good choices here. We'll see if any of them come up. Gary?
That's probably the right answer, but I said judge.
Judge is good. I think that's probably a little better than lawyer, but they're both acceptable.
No, the trick, you haven't got onto this yet. The trick of this game is to match the contestants.
Oh, is that the way it goes?
Ta-da, lawyer.
Oh, thank you. There's one for you, Maria. What do you say, Charles?
Jury.
A jury is good. That's a good possibility. You're playing with my microphone cable,
I know that.
Mary.
Well, I'm crazy about you.
She's pulling the microphone cable and drawing me to her.
Want to know what I said?
What do you want to say there?
I said she brought a judge.
Here come the judge. Here
you know come
the
judge. What it is, a
judge.
Trial.
Yeah, that's
Thank
what it
you,
is.
All, right. both of you.
Here come another judge.
Well, here that two judge we got. And what
wrote,
do you say?
You wrote training bra first.
Yes, I did write training
judge.
Bra.
Judge.
All right. Well, lawyer was good, judge was good, jury was good. That's the way it goes. Yours will be along later, but right now we got to do business with America. This is it. And that's where we are, and here we go. Madeline, this is your first rounder. It reads as follows. At the sideshow, Fred said, that two-headed man is disgusting. He has a double case of blank.
Mercy!
Two-headed man is disgusting. He has a double case of blank.
That is two-headed man.
Oh, I got it. Gee, I'm getting smarter.
Yeah,
so quick around here lately. What's happened, Joe?
Double case, a two-headed man.
Gotcha. Oh, and that is bad.
Cute.
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 Not bad.
Same to you, fella.
Two-headed man.
Oh, well, wait a minute. I just thought of something better.
Aren't you a creative person?
Yeah,
terrific.
I liked it better. Not quite as
disgusting. I don't like that answer,
Is it two-headed man?
He has a double case of...
That two-headed man is disgusting. He has a double case of blank.
That, Betty. I know you can.
I know.
We know you're up to it, Betty. Your mother's in the audience, Betty.
Stop. And she hasn't been well. We don't want to pressure you.
You don't want to disgrace your mother, Betty.
Alan may be watching.
Oh, yeah. Her mother was disgraced the day she was born.
Oh. Okay, Madeline. At the sideshow, Fred said that two-headed man is disgusting. He has a double case of...
Dandruff.
Dandruff is the perfect
Get
answer.
Get it, Betty!
Two-headed man. Two-headed man.
I didn't know.
If I said it once, I said it 80 times. Two-headed man.
Oh, I'm here to...
No, there was room for two Kojaks. I said bad breath.
Oh, all right. That... A possibility.
I'm sorry, I said better.
It's okay. Dandruff is a better answer, but what the heck? What do you say?
Dandruff's a better answer?
Than bad breath? I think so.
Wait a minute.
Ta-da-da! All right, Madeline, that's one for you.
I don't think it's that good.
Charles? No. She only has one head.
I'm sorry. I said bad breath.
Okay. Plural.
I like this.
Score is tied 1-1. Now, Mary.
Listen.
He has a double case of dandruff.
You know I'm always on the side of a winner. Dandruff.
Dandruff it is. That's Peter Madeline. Oh, you say, Ricky?
The key words were two-headed, right?
Yeah. Two-headed, right.
And disgusting.
Yeah?
It's
dandruff is not really disgusting.
You don't find dandruff disgusting? I think it's absolutely
bad breath
revolting. Look at that.
But just don't breathe on me, Gene. I hate that.
Now, you want to see a rotten answer? Wait till this little lady shows some
talent. I don't think we've had it. I think dandruff is a flaky answer. I think they're all... I said post-nasal drip, which is...
Oh! That is disgusting.
Remember how long it took her to get it?
Yes. She worked on that. So the score is 2-1 now, and here we go with round two. Maria?
I'll stay with A.
A it is. You matched one person last time. That's Brett. The rest of you do this. You know how some babies are born with a silver spoon in their mouth? Well, when President Ford was born, he had a silver blank in his mouth. Okay. Good. Good, good.
Not good,
terrific.
Bad.
No, that's a good answer.
Mm-hmm.
There. What's wrong with that?
Well...
There's nothing wrong with that. Come on, Charles.
I don't know.
Okay, Maria. You know, some babies are born with a silver spoon in their mouth. Well, when President Ford was born, he had a silver blank in his mouth.
I drew a blank.
You drew a blank on it?
I drew a blank.
Well, two of them over there did, too. Apparently, some people have difficulty with this. But you must say something. Now, just think about it. Some babies are born with a silver spoon in their mouth. When President Ford was born, he had a silver blank in his mouth.
I'll just say knife.
A knife?
Yeah.
Yes. Well, now she said something. She didn't, you know, all right, Gary.
I don't have any idea why I said fork.
I don't either. Charles, what'd you say?
I said four.
Four. And what do you say?
I said foot.
Foot is the answer. Hey! Foot. And we got foot, and we got foot over there. Ding, 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 ding. That means the Madeline Single won the game. Congratulations. Come on down, Madeline.
We have time.
Okay. Don't go up the place now. You hang around over here. Maria, it was a pleasure to meet you. We're going to send some gifts to you, a 9-year supply of pantyhose and all kinds of marvelous things. And we thank you for being with us in Match Game 76. Maria Whitley. Goodbye, my dear. Next time for Match Game 76.